Welcome all in our today's lecture. So in this lecture we are solving some examples of work done. So formula for work done and line integral is said. So first of all, in this first example of work done, I have a given thing, given f bar is equal to 3x square I bar plus 2xz minus y into j bar plus z into k. So this is given vector point function. In this case, this is a force. Okay. Along the curve, x square is equal to 4y and 3x cube is equal to 8z. Okay. So therefore, work done is equal to integral, circular integral over c of f bar dot dr bar. So this is equal to circular integral over c of f1 dx plus f2 dy plus f3 dz. So which is equal to integration over c of f1 become 3x square into dx. Okay, so this is our f1 which is multiplied to I bar. This function is f2 and this is our f3. So plus f2 into dy. So 2xz minus y into dy plus f3 into dz means z into dz. So we required this integral, circular integral, that means our work. So given curve is x square is equal to 4y, 3x cube is equal to 8z from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. Okay, so these are given curves. In this case we can write y and z in terms of x, or instead of that we can use one parameter. So use substitution, put instead of x I will use 2t. I am not using just t, I am using 2t, because by putting here x by 2t we get 4t square and this 4 and 4 will get cancelled. So that's why I will put x is equal to 2t, and therefore x square is equal to 4y implies 2t bracket square is equal to 4y. So this implies 4t square is equal to 4y, and therefore we get y square become t square. Sorry, y become t square. Now, and 3x cube is equal to 8z implies 3 into 2t bracket cube is equal to 8z. So this implies 3 into 8t cube is equal to 8z. And finally this 8 will get cancelled and we get 3t cube is equal to z. So in that way we get x, y, z in parameter t. Now limit. For x is equal to, we have given limit for x. So x is equal to 0 implies, therefore x is equal to 2t implies 0 is equal to 2t. So this implies 0 is equal to t. So this is lower limit for t. And for x is equal to 2, x is equal to 2t implies 2 is equal to 2t. So this implies t is equal to 1. So in that way very easily we can find limit for t. Okay, this is our equation number 1. Therefore equation 1 become, so equation 1 is work done equal to integration t is equal to 0 to 1. Okay, t varies from 0 to 1. 3x square, so 3 into value of x is 2t. So 2t bracket square into dx, value of dx So before writing integral, we should first find value of dx dy dz. So here x is equal to 2t, y is equal to t square, and z is equal to 3t cube. Differentiating, we get derivative of x is 1 into dx is equal to 2 into derivative of t is 1 into dt, comma derivative of y is 1 into dy, then derivative of t square is 2t dt, derivative of z is 1 into dz, derivative of t cube is 3 t square, means 9 t square dt. Therefore equation 1 becomes, now use all these values in our equation number 1. So therefore work done is equal to, put all these values in equation 1. So here work done is equal to integration t is equal to 0 to 1 into bracket 3x square. Here we don't need bracket 3 as it is. Instead of x we are replacing 2t. So x square into dx, value of dx is 2 dt. Then plus sign in bracket 2xz, value of x is 2t into value of z is 3t cube minus value of y is t square, bracket complete, into dy, value of dy is 2t dt. Then plus sign, value of z is 3t cube into dz, value of dz is 9t square dt. Now simplify this integrand. So we get integration t is equal to 0 to 1 into bracket square of this term become 4t square. 4t square into 3 into 2 become 24t square. Then this term become plus into bracket 4 into 3, 12 t raised to 4 minus t square into 2t, plus this one become 27 into t raised to 5, bracket complete dt. Now finally we get t is equal to 0 to 1 into bracket 24 t square, plus multiply this 2t inside the bracket, so we get 24 t raised to 5, then minus 2 t raised to 3 plus 27 t raised to 5, bracket complete dt. And now integrate this, you can integrate this very easily. So before that, I will first add these two terms. So integration t is equal to 0 to 1 become 24 plus 27 become 51, right, 51 t raised to 5 plus minus 2t cube plus 24t square dt. Now this is equal to integration t is equal to 0 to 1. I will directly integrate this. We get 51 t raised to 6 divided by 6 minus 2t raised to 4 divided by 4 plus 24 t raised to 3 divided by 3. Limit from t is equal to 0 to 1. Now by putting limit, we get, first put upper limit t by 1, 1 raised to anything become 1, so we get 51 divided by 6 minus 2 divided by 4 plus 24 divided by 3 minus, by putting lower limit all terms become 0. And now simplify this, we get, first make denominator same for first and last term, so we get 51 divided by 6 plus, multiply and divide by 2 to this term, we get 48 divided by 6 minus 2 divided by 4 as it is, or we can write this 2 divided by 4 as 1 divided by 2. Okay, so this term becomes 2 divided by 2. And now we get denominator becomes same 6, take addition of numerator, we get 50 plus 40 is 99 divided by 6 minus 1 upon 2. Right? Now again dividing by 3, we get 2 and here we come 3, 3. So finally we get 3, 3 minus 1 divided by 2, because denominator is same. We get 32 divided by 2, and this becomes 16. 16 is our final answer, which is our required one work done for this force along the given curve from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. Okay. Second example on work done is find work done in moving a particle in a force field F bar. This is given F bar along the curve x is equal to t square plus 1, y is equal to 2t square, and z is equal to t3. From t is equal to 1 to t is equal to 2. That means we have given a parametric equation of given curve and we require to find work done. So formula become integration over c of f bar dot d bar dr. So this is equal to integration over c of f1 dx plus f2 dy plus f3 dz. Here f1 is 3xy, so 3xy dx. Then fy, f2 is minus 5z, so minus 5z into dy. And f3 is 10x, so plus 10x into dz. So given curves are x is equal to t square plus 1, y is equal to 2t square, and z is equal to t cube. So differentiate this, we get dx is equal to 2t dt, then dy is equal to 4t dt, and dz become 3t square dt. Now find limit for t at x is equal to, we have given limit for t also, so t is equal to 1 to t is equal to 2, which is given. So no need to find these limits, which are actually we have given, and now use all this thing in our equation number 1. So therefore 1 become work done is equal to integration from t is equal to 0 to 1. First function is 3xy into dx. So 3 as it is, value of x is t square plus 1 in terms of t, into value of y is 2t square, into dx is 2t dt. Then minus 5z, 5 as it is, value of z is t cube, into dy, value of dy is 4t dt. Then plus sine 10x, 10 as it is, value of x is t square plus 1, into dz, value of dz is 3t square dt. And now simplify this, we get work done become integration t is equal to 0 to 1 into bracket. After simplifying this, we get 4t cube, 4t cube into 3 become 12t cube into t square become 12t raised to 5 plus 12t cube into 1 become 12t cube. Okay. Similarly, simplify this, we get minus 20t raised to 4. And now simplify this, we get 10 into 3 is 30. 30t square into t square become plus 30t raised to 4. Plus 30 t square into 1 become 30 t square, and 10 dt common. In that way we can directly simplify this, and now we get integration t is equal to 0 to 1. And now take addition of same power term, so power term of 5 is single, so write it as it is, 12 t raised to 5. Power with 4 are two terms, so this become plus 10 t raised to 4, then plus 12 t cube, and plus 30 t square. It's integration with respect to t. Now integrate, we get in bracket 12 as it is, into t raised to 6 divided by 6, then plus sine 10 as it is, into t raised to 5 divided by 5, then plus sine 12 as it is, into t cube, integration of t cube is t raised to 4 divided by 4, then plus 30 as it is, integration of t square is t cube divided by 3, limit from t is equal to 1 to 2. Okay, limits are from 1 to 2. Okay, we have given t is equal to 1 to t is equal to 2. So 1 to 2. 1, 2, 2. Okay. Now simplify this, we get 2t raised to 6 plus 2t raised to 5 plus 3t raised to 4 plus 10t raised to 3, limit from 1 to 2. So first of all, put upper limit, which is 2, 2 raised to 6 plus 2 into 2 raised to 5 plus 3 into 2 raised to 4 plus 10 into 2 raised to 3, and then minus sign and put lower limit. We get 2 plus 2 plus 3 plus 10. And now simplify this, we get 2 raised to 6 become 64, right? 2 raised to 6.64 into 2 is 128 plus 2 raised to 5 32 32 into 2 64 plus 2 raised to 4 16 16 into 3 48 plus 2 raised to 3 is 8 into 10 80 minus this become 70. So in that way we get, after subtracting 70, so we get 111 plus this become 120, 64 plus addition of these two term become 128. So final addition become 8 plus 4 is 2 and 12 plus 1 is 30. So 2 plus 1 3, 3 plus 1 4 plus 6 is 10. So 303 is our final answer. So in that way we can easily calculate the work done for given force field. Okay, so just look this. Third example on work done is, find the work done in a moving particle once round the ellipse x square upon 16 plus y square upon 4 is equal to 1 comma z is equal to 0 under the field of force given by F bar is equal to this force field. Is this field conservative? So first of all, find work done. So now first I have given force field F bar. So in that case, this become our F1, this is our F2, and this is our F3. So right, formula for work done is equal to circular integral over C of F bar dot dr bar. So this become integration over C F1 dx plus F2 dy plus F3 dz. Now this is equal to integration over C of F1 is 2x minus y plus z into dx plus F2 become x plus y minus z square into dy plus 3x minus 2y plus 4z into dz. Okay, now given curl is x square upon 16 plus y square upon 4 is equal to 1 comma z is equal to 0. So use polar coordinate, x is equal to a cos theta. So here a become square root of 16, which is 4 cos theta. Y is equal to b sin theta. In this case b square is 4, so b is equal to 2, so 2 sin theta. Okay, now differentiate this, we get dx is equal to minus 4 sin theta d theta, dy is equal to 2 cos theta d theta. Okay, derivative of x and y, and now limits for theta. Theta is equal to 0 to theta is equal to 2 pi, because our ellipse particle once round the ellipse, it completes a one round around the ellipse, so theta rise from 0 to 2 pi, and therefore this integral or work done is equal to integration from theta is equal to 0 to 2 pi in first bracket 2x minus y plus z, here 2 as it is, in इनटू वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स इज 4 कॉस थीटा देन माइनस वाई वैल्यू ऑफ वाई इज 2 साइन थीटा एंड वैल्यू ऑफ जेड इज 0 which is given z is equal to 0 into dx value of dx is minus 4 sin theta d theta. Next term is plus into bracket value of x is 4 cos theta then plus sin value of y is 2 sin theta minus z square but value of z is 0 so this term will become 0 into dy value of dy is 2 cos theta d theta plus if z is equal to 0 so this implied dz is also 0 so this dz is 0 then this total term also 0 now simplify this we get integration 0 to 2 pi then multiplying minus 4 sin theta inside the bracket we get 2 into 4 is 8 8 into minus 4 minus 32 sin theta into cos theta, right? Sin theta into cos theta, then this minus into minus plus, 2 into 4 is 8, sin theta into sin theta becomes sin square theta, next term become 2 cos theta into 4 become plus 8 cos square theta, and last term become plus 2 into 2 become plus 4, sin theta cos theta bracket complete d theta now simplify this we get theta is equal to 0 to 2 pi now this term and this term are same with different coefficients so minus 32 plus 4 become minus 28 sin theta cos theta plus take 8 common from these two terms, we get 8 into bracket sin square theta plus cos square theta bracket complete to d theta. And now separate the integral. So we get minus 28 integration 0 to 2 pi sin theta into cos theta d theta. And next term become plus 8 into integration 1 d theta from 0 to 2 pi since sin square theta plus cos square theta become 1. Okay, and now this is equal to 0 plus 8 into theta limit from 0 to 2 pi since by reduction formula integration 0 to 2 pi sin raised to m theta into cos raised to n theta d theta is equal to 4 times integration 0 to pi by 2 sin raised to n theta into cos raised to n theta d theta if n both even and this becomes 0 otherwise. So here m and n both are odd that's why this integral becomes 0 using this reduction formula and therefore work done is equal to so here is theta okay integration of one is theta so 8 into bracket 2 pi minus 0 so which is equal to 16 pi so this is our final answer so in that way we can find the work done of given force field under given curve.